Okay guys, welcome back to the channel. Got a fun video today of a visit I did to an audiophile's house in Houston who has a fabulous system. And this one has pretty unique gear that I can't even get it locally here in Houston. 3MA doesn't even carry many things that this guy owns. Although he's kind of a customer for some of the things that he's had done to his room and some of the build outs and things he's going to be doing in the future. So 3MA is going to probably be working with him. And actually, he's had some really interesting anecdotal stories over the years of dealing with certain brands and certain dealers outside of Houston. And it was pretty revelatory and consistent with what I've seen over the years. You know, before I even get into talking about his system, one of the takeaways today is that my experiences and have been echoed a million times. It's really important to find a good dealer and good brands that stand behind their product. He had some major problems with some subs he bought and a dealer he dealt with. And it was unfortunate to hear his situation with that. I don't have to, you know, every subwoofer has susceptibility to the digital amps failing. That's just a common problem among especially certain brands. I wouldn't have expected it with his brands that he had. But me just buying a REL sub, I feel so much more confident in the brand REL, how they stand behind stuff, number one. But number two, I know if I ever have any trouble, 3MA will, you know, they'll loan me a sub in the interim while they get it fixed or just send replacement parts. That's an important thing to factor into your buying decisions based on here's a guy that costs no object stuff and he's no longer dealing with dealers he used to deal with in the past because they just didn't treat him right. And so anyway, getting back though on topic with his system, it's a fabulous system. He's got some great gear. It's Avalon Isis speakers, which are really cost no object speakers, and Spectral gear all the way. You'll see video of his equipment rack as well as his amps. And if you know Spectral gear, they require the use of MIT cables. And it is very synergistic to have all Spectral gear as well with the MIT cables. Makes it a lot easier for you if you buy into their gear and want make it simple. You know, just go ahead and get everything and get the cabling. You don't have to worry about being on a merry-go-round or trying to match stuff yourself. And the proof pays off, at least in his case. The sound was exceptional. The Avalons were tremendous speakers. I've always liked Avalons. And anecdotally, it's one of the few brands that I heard, I think it was Albert von Schweikert at one of the shows many, many years ago when he was kind of still doing more reasonable price speakers, not even cost no object. I overheard him at a show talking about three brands that he was, you know, considered most competitors, the most competitive and most one that he wanted to, you know, be able to beat. And I know Avalon was one of them. And especially back in the early 2000s, Avalon was quite well known. And I think they mainly do the Asian market now. So in North America, they probably aren't as prominent. And I know just getting a hold of them now is a little bit tougher. But their speakers are very well designed, you know, just solid cabinets with no resonances. They've got the interesting baffle arrangements with diffraction. And so that it limits the baffle reflections and stuff. And the way they integrate a diamond tweeter, at least that's what was in this speaker, I'm told, the Isis. I'm not that familiar with the Isis, but it was a diamond tweeter with ceramic mid-range. And you would normally think ceramic, diamond tweeter, okay, I've heard that, you know, countless times before. It's going to be very detailed, very aggressive. There's a signature sound to that. And I can tell you that it was anything but what I expected and dramatically different from what I expected. The level of integration and coherence and just naturalness, I thought I was listening to, you know, a British mid-range speaker, and the voices were among the best I've heard. Now, it's not just the gear. The guy has a phenomenal room. It's just huge ceilings, but none of that echo that you normally hear with high ceiling rooms. Treatments everywhere, meticulous attention paid to sonics and placement and setup. So this was a treat, not just from the gear perspective, but from the room. And it showed what was capable. Like I was able to really find memorable moments. I've heard lots of gear. You've just seen a fraction on my channel, but I've gone to countless shows over the years and tons of stuff I don't video. So if I find something really memorable, that's something. And today was definitely memorable because one of the fun things is that every track he played was something that was pretty much on my reference playlist. So I knew some of these tracks he played inside and out, everything from Jennifer Warnes. He's at the Enya, but I don't have that on my track, but he played that. That was good. Doug McLeod, Natalie Merchant, some other things that we played. John Rutter Requiem was one of the best reproductions of John Rutter's Requiem, the Turtle Creek Choir, that I've ever heard. And I've heard that a lot at shows. Almost everybody wants to play that track for pipe organ. And while he was missing his subs, the Isis was more than capable of presenting that enjoyment of that track at the pipe organ level. Certainly you could benchmark things at the top end or the bottom end without the subs that, maybe the MBL Extremes might do this better or whatever. But as a coherent total package of room and everything, that room with the Isis and the Spectral gear was extremely memorable and definitely reference quality, and amazing how it's able to get those drivers to perform in a fashion where you think it's not the typical ceramic diamond tweeter combination. So I'll play some tracks for you and also give you two other tips that I learned. It's very important to audition things with a lot of different music, and then also audition things at different volume levels. Because I can tell you, when I first sat down, the volume level was very low, and the track was one that I was familiar with, but not super familiar with. So at first I was like, okay, this is really nice sounding. And a lot of people go to these shows or even to a dealer, and even these reviewers, they got like 3 or 4 tracks that they mention in the review. And I'm like, that is not sufficient to really get an appreciation. It was only once we started playing stuff at the wide range of variety, from the Turtle Creek Choir, John Rutter Requiem, to pop, to jazz, to other things, Jennifer Warren's vocals, male vocals, and then at different volume levels, when the speakers can wake up more and interact with the room and give you that dynamic and feel and energy that's very important with certain type of music that you play. So that's when I really gained an appreciation for the equipment and the room, because as you turn this up, you didn't want to turn it down. So that's kind of a primitive litmus test, but a very important one. It only got better as you turned it up and up. And I can't say that for even some mega dollar systems I've heard, and rooms, again, it's the two combined. Things start rattling, things start echoing, things start being problematic sometimes, even with the best gear, as you raise the volume. So that was two things to take away from here. Don't trust reviews that they only played 4 or 5 tracks or less. Don't trust unless they play different volume levels and give you a report at different volume levels. I would say that this speaker is actually kind of more subdued, believe it or not, even with the ceramic drivers and diamond tweeter. If you listen at super low volume levels, you might even find it's not even that exciting. But it really pays off when you play at normal volume listenings or higher. Then it wakes up and it's really impressive to a level that, man, you kind of like that tonal balance and performance level, even better in some areas than things like the MBL Extremes. I went back to 3MA after the demo, and we played some of the same tracks, or at least I did, and sat and listened. And so it's not a slam dunk that MBL Extremes, even at their price point, are better than these Avalon Isis. There's certain areas where, you know, I can appreciate what the Avalons did. But again, bass performance, there's a much bigger difference. But again, lots of fun. You're not going to be able to tell much from the clips in terms of audio, but I'll give you a few. Check them out. Hopefully enjoy it. And I'll be back soon with more.
Yeah, so we got Spectral gear.
Bassist turntable. It's under the black cover there. I can show you that later.
Yeah, and
this audio technology.
Render.
That's a Render W20? SC or that's?
It's the previous one.
The previous one, okay. And it's got the MC205 for the home theater and a DataSat
in the
processor.
That Sony CD/SACD DVD player is pretty amazing box.
It's better than the Oppo.
Oh, it's better than the Oppo.
Oppo 205.
I have, like, you want to buy the Oppo? No,
the
I'm going to do it. Yeah, I think that's what I have.
Wow, okay, what's wrong with it?
The Oppo?
This sounds
nothing. Better. This sounds amazing.
So you use the last products, you find that it helps?
Yeah.
Cool. Nice. And what cartridge are you using?
So it's the Lyra Atlas.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Some of my friends have that. That's nice.
Yeah. If you want to, you know, with the LP, if you want to hear some of that, we can do it. But you have to listen to one side before it really warms up and you can hear it.
Yes,
I'll be glad to do that if you want, since you're...
Oh, that's impressive.
Aficionados. The impressive part is when you sit down and listen.
Sure. So.
And this room has a lot to do with the way this sounds.
It's a beautiful room. Yeah, it's got treatments all over. So.
Yeah, I remember we were here helping.
The real sexy part, though.
That was amazing.
It was
that was fun.
It was
Let me pivot to the speakers here.
Do you want me to pull the curtains up so you can get better light?
That's fine. I mean. And the nice Spectral amps, and I bet you're using MIT cables, huh?
Uh-huh.
Yep, they require it, yep.
They're required.
And room treatments, so that's a projector up there.
Yep.
Nice. And then you have...
Today's first meeting, once we installed that screen up there, the projector's up here.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
It comes down.
Yeah, you want to show them? Does it still work?
Oh yeah, it does.
That would be amazing.
But I think I'm going to go to, I think I told you I'm going to do something fixed.
Yeah.
I'm going to do this. Do you want to?
Ready for it?
Alright, so that's badass.
It's a pain in the badass.
Yeah, I'm sure. That's cool.
Yes.
Was that on top of at all?
No, this is fun.
We did that.
This is fun.
We did that.
The only thing
is the age, like the fabric.
This never came out. It's got those wrinkles. But
yeah,
frankly,
so
you don't
weird,
see
it
in
like,
the picture.
Stuart, I don't know why don't they actually put this involved. We have the same problem at the school.
Really?
Yeah, it seems like a fact, never fact. You see?
Yeah,
it seems like it's just over time.
I would have thought it would flatten out, but it didn't.
Are you going to change out this different screen or just going to leave it? You don't watch that much movie, and that would justify a new screen.
So, lots of thoughts about the screen.
Yeah.
I don't think
that's pretty amazing.
Did you see it just blink on and off?
Yeah.
So we'll talk about that later. I don't think I get anything.
All right, now we'll do some listening in a second. Thank you.
from her comb down to her shoes, but she's just an invitation to the blues. But you feel like Kathy, and she looks like Rita Hayworth at the counter of the Schwab drugstore. You wonder if she might be single. She's a loner, likes to mingle. Got to be patient, try to pick up a clue, she says. How you gonna like her? Medium or scrambled? Anyway's the only way. Be careful not to gamble on a guy with a suitcase. Ticket getting out of here. It's a tight bus station. Until a new one comes along. I spoke to you in cautious tones. You answered me with no pretense. And still I fear I've said too much. My silence is my self-defense. For every time I've held a rose, it seems I only felt the thorn. And so it goes, and so it goes, and so will you soon, I suppose. But if my silence made you leave, then that would be my worst mistake. So I will share this room with you, and you can have this heart to break. And in the stillness of the evening, I heard a rustling in the leaves, and I saw a panther in the yard, moving slow across the ledge, with silver eyes and a cool and hunger with a cutting edge. Open the door, let it in. This mystery you found, oh, it's all. Heart to break.